I am here today at Mind the Tech Tel Aviv. Today we have joining me Ze'ev Fardman, the CEO of Lightrix, the company behind photo editing app Facetune. Hello.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Thank you very much for joining us today.
Pleasure.
So Facetune had recently raised a Series C funding round of $135 million.
Okay, but you know what? Even before that, let me clarify. Lightrix is the company behind Facetune, and by now we have a diversified portfolio of products split into the three product division. Mm-hmm. So Facetune is in the consumer division. Okay, and Light is in the prosumer division.
Okay.
And Boost is our suite of tools for small businesses. That's how we're structured at the moment.
Okay. So now that you've raised a very substantial funding round, what's next?
Well, we really believe that with time, more and more people will be interested to create content. It could be in order to promote their personal brand on social networks. It could be in order to promote their business. And we want to be the creativity company for the masses. We basically want to democratize creativity and bring content creation to everyone.
Is an IPO something that's planned in the near future potentially?
Well, I mean, at the moment, I think it's a great time to be a growth stage company in the private markets, right? There is abundance of capital. We can rise, you know, to a company of hundreds of employees, hundreds of million dollars in revenues to really high valuations on the private markets. But at some point, I think with the trajectory of a company like ours, IPO is something that we should really consider. And I think it's definitely down the line a couple of years from now.
I know that you said you have three branches, but I'd like to focus on Facetune for just a moment. I was just wondering, what are the most popular features on the app that users use?
Well, Facetune started with the really simple features like, you know, smoothing your skin, whitening your teeth, making your eye more pronounced. Mm-hmm. And still, these are the features that for users are kind of easiest to get into. With time, we introduced more complex things like a changing the illumination of your face after the selfie was already captured and things like that. So with time, we're seeing shift to these kind of more advanced features. But I think the basics of Facetune are still there. Just, you know, like smoothing your skin, whitening your teeth, making your gaze more pronounced.
And how is the company coping with the shortage of manpower in the field in Israel?
Well, at some point, we actually thought that in our case, it's going to be worse because we're based in Jerusalem and not even in Tel Aviv and Herzliya. So many people were skeptical around our ability to attract top talent in Jerusalem. And I think counterintuitively, what happened is that actually it's kind of easier for us because I think there is less competition for talent in Jerusalem. And, you know, we're sitting inside the campus of Hebrew U. This gives us an opportunity to start engaging with top talent really early on during their undergrad studies. We have, you know, a internship, student positions. We try to attract top talent early on and then to retain it inside the company. And, you know, it worked great for us. We're actually outpacing our hiring projection. We're supposed to finish the year with 300 employees. Is going to be 350, so we are outpacing our projections at the moment.
Amazing. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
And best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.